rain forecast at all for this Grand Prix here today, and yet those images perhaps tell you different. Are we going to see some rainfall here before MotoGP go racing in just over half an hour?
We have the best pace. We started in FP3, was P1, FP4, P1, qualifying P1. That moment was moment to make a gap in the championship. But Joan was far away, a key moment for the championship there. And you arrive to the race, and just before starting, there is some rain coming, and you say, no way. And you go to the box, and then you see heavy rain. So, okay, be calm, it's your first race in MotoGP in the wet, and just do your best.
I think Frankie last year was supposed to be the rider, the number one rider, you know?
He was the one who had experience, the one who should be there, make results. Target was always top six with him to finish there and make his first podium. And then, as we all know, everything changed.
He was very much overshadowed by Fabio.
The problem was my teammate.
Fabio became very strong from Qatar. Frankie was going down. Mentally, it was very tough for him because he had the better bike at that point, and Fabio was a fresh rookie and enjoying everything.
The Italian, who was the next great hope in the Yamaha system, but he's being overshadowed quite comprehensively right now by his teammate, Fabio Quartararo.
He was doing better than me, and I wasn't expecting that.
Fabio Quartararo is now pouncing. He moves up into second. He uses the superior corner speed of his Yamaha. Fabio Quartararo up to P2.
The bike of last year, everywhere you go, from the first lap, you feel that everything is going well.
And Fabio Quartararo is on the podium for the first time.
I wasn't happy with getting beaten by my teammate.
Fabio Quartararo. The rising star, the rookie sensation.
Everything is going so well during all your start of MotoGP season. You make 7 podiums, 6 pole position.
Franco Morbidelli, tough day yesterday, only 14th place, his worst qualifying since Valencia.
I remember that Wilco told me that they would have liked to make 200 points with me last year, but I think we didn't get even close.
That's such a shame. Morbidelli's gone down at turn number 7. Fabio Quartararo, what a performance. Franco Morbidelli, the pressure building undoubtedly on the shoulders of this young man.
It was a magnificent race from the rookie, and he will have his day. Quartararo makes it back-to-back podiums, and that is great stuff from the rookie.
So while Frankie was building some pressure on his side and the results didn't arrive, Fabio was just enjoying his first year in MotoGP and was just going from one race to the next in a fantastic way. So many pole positions, so many podiums. So that was hard for Frankie.
No! Oh, that's Morbidelli and Rins further down at turn number 12.
It was a positive year, 2019, but it's a year where I started and I learned that I needed to get better, just get better.
The target this year was to try and win, at least one, because we know that the last time an independent Yamaha team have won a race was 20 years ago.
We, of course, had high expectations going into 2020. We had a good pre-season test with Fabio, also Frankie, and we felt strong. You know, we felt strong in Sepang, in Qatar.
Pace was really fast. If I'm not wrong, there we was one of the fastest.
We wanted to do clearly better than last year, and to set that motivation, actually, that was already a high one.
So okay, we need to bring that victory and to fight until the end of the season. I was really preparing myself so strong at home. I was so fit, and just before leaving, we heard about the bad news.
Das Coronavirus breitet sich weiter aus.
Futebol de quarentena em Portugal devido à pandemia de Covid-19.
Informação relativa à emergência coronavírus com os últimos aggiornamenti.
Unfortunately, at that time, then Covid hit us and we couldn't start the season as we were hoping for.
Die Ausbreitung des Coronavirus hat jetzt auch Auswirkungen auf die Motorrad-WM.
What's happened for the future? This is something we cannot prevent. Then this depends every day the situation changes all around the world, and the only thing I say is we will try to do everything possible, or to postpone, or to do whatever. Our aim today is to work together, as we have been doing all this time, to try to make the championship in the best possible conditions, but to try to maintain the championship and the maximum number of races we can.
For us was cancelled, and then we went in this big lockdown and corona situation.
Nobody have been in this position ever before, especially for us being in our second year.
And we learned to work from home via, you know, Skype or Zoom or any online meetings, you know, and we had to do it. And everyone, I think, managed that really well.
Well, I've not been doing too much. Training, and lucky enough, I have a gym in the house.
I'm training hard. We need to stay fit.
Okay, Frankie, good to see you here. Looking fit and well there, despite being locked up at home. Nice race suit behind you there.
COVID, in this case, helped a lot in the way that I just could have trained and come back home and train and go back home.
Frankie became more determined, trained harder, focused more.
Checking the videos and understanding step by step how he should ride the Yamaha, that improved his skills and his riding.
He works extremely hard in the off-season. During lockdown, during the winter season, and he comes back really, really strong.
He knew he would be on a lesser package, let's say a different package than Fabio and the other two Yamaha riders. But he said, I won't care.
This year, my aim wasn't just to beat my teammate. My first aim was to be a better rider, to be a better athlete.
Thank goodness that everything went well. I mean, the championship went ahead. After 3 months, 4 months lockdown, it's good to be out of their comfort zone. And everybody is excited, but at the same time, we are nervous of traveling to Jerez.
Also, after many months without riding, was great to be back.
I mean, Fabio was already, before Jerez, coming to Jerez, the first race, was very motivated. He was very hungry. He was training very hard in the COVID and lockdown.
media, TVs, before to start the season, everybody says, what happened if you don't win any race?
And Fabio's pace?
Difficult to judge. Mark was faster in FP4, clear, but it was 2-3 tenths, but his tires were newer. The bottom line of this race will be the last 4-5 laps, or the main laps, because if you have something still to fight with, will be difficult because the tire degradation is high.
Yeah, not forgetting Vinales is also very fast.
I think that's what I want to say. I think there's the three guys, because if you see the qualifying was a big gap actually to P5, like with Miller, so it was 0.7.
Yeah,
it's a very big step. Huh?
Yes.
So I think it's Maverick, it's Fabio, and Mark, you know, this is the guys who are going to fight today, and I think they will get away in the beginning. I think that's the key, don't you think so? That also get a big gap.
So are we confident? Is this the round? Is this the race?
We are confident, we are competitive, that's for sure.
We have a chance. We have a big chance, and I think we have, I'm confident.
Welcome back to Jerez, 8 months, and now we're back again to start 2020. And away we go. Good start from Maverick Vinales. He's got that bike absolutely flying. Marquez did not get away well. Here comes Quartararo. He had to get that done. Brilliantly done, but he's run it wide and oh, blimey.
Squeezed back the eye on the curb on the inside there, didn't he?
Strikes back again on the brakes into the Pedrosa corner. Turn 6, the end of the back straight. Oh, he's gone! He's gone! Marquez. We lost sight of Marquez. He stayed on board, but what's happened?
Well, actually, he was in front of me when he go in the gravel, but I was not expecting him to come back that fast. So I never really had the chance to see on the board that Mark was behind.
Here comes Fabio Quartararo. He wants to make it a Yamaha 1-2. He's up the inside of Jack Miller, but does he run it wide? No, he manages to hold off.
So it was only Maverick, Jack.
Look at that, he's wide in there, and Fabio Quartararo takes the lead. Maverick Vinales is struggling.
I think it was one of my best races I've been fighting with the Ducatis, with Maverick, we pull away. We have already 5 seconds. The pressure of going for your first win was there, so from mid-race to the end, I was much more calm.
Fabio Quartararo wins his first ever Grand Prix in MotoGP. France has a hero again.
The most memorable day of my life. I can't describe it. It's something that you live for. Wow, what a satisfaction. It was unbelievable, a dream come true.
Something, yes, released from you, because we've been working very hard for it. We knew we have the capacity to win. And once you achieve it, it's a great feeling.
When it's done, you also can relieve and say, okay, I win this race. Now we can focus on our job to be constant, you know?
I didn't feel pressure, but at that time you feel that something less to think about, and it was great, and also the feeling was amazing.
For him was also a nice reward to win, and to, you know, for all the hard work putting in from his side.
I'm considered new in the sport, you know. We have guys who have been here for longer than us, have not even tasted their win, especially in MotoGP, you know.
I remember it, and I will always remember it the rest of my life, because it's the first win in MotoGP for so many of us in the team.
Never can I imagine at such a short period of time for us to get our first win.
Little noise you hear, there's a little bit unusual. He's going to be thinking, oh, please no, please no.
And do you know what would make it worse? Is if he sees P2. Oh, Marquez is down. He's gone again. Oh, that's a big crash. He's
huge.
Not saving that one. I hope he's all right, because that's a fast one.
Is that four again?
It's four again. It's caught him out once more.
It's unfortunate for Mark to crash out so early in the year, which resulted in him not racing at all in the championship.
We were feeling strong, especially with Mark not in the competition and having this big injury. We also realized that this is a very important season.
start from Fabio Quartararo. He got that one absolutely nailed. He's flying up the hill at Vinales. It's going to be a Yamaha 1-2-3. Quartararo leads into turn one.
I think that the two race in Jerez, we were more ready than the others.
Oh, inside, no, he's wide. Well wide. He loses out. He drops back to third.
3.6 seconds clear. Fabio Quartararo cruising to his second successive victory. The first French rider to do that in Premier Class history.
It's huge for him, it's huge for France. You know, so we're so happy for him. It's also huge for us. We are only in our second year and already we have the first two wins. It's incredible.
Of course, in my mind was to fight for the championship.
But the good thing is we have experienced people, like I said, with Wilco and some of the guys who have been there before. They help new guys like me and Johan and other two. Okay, calm down, you know, let's take a step back and just don't think about the World Championship. We go approach it race, one race at a time.
Back to back to back to back pole position. To back to back. Okay. I will talk to Carmelo to have one more race for Jerez this week.